Good evening, and we'd like to welcome you all to our annual African American celebration of the Albany Common Council. We'd like to say congratulations to all those participants that are being recognized by their Common Council member for the many attributes and contributions they've made to the city of Albany. We've known in the past year and this year we've dealt with COVID, and that's why we're doing this virtual. The pandemic has ripped through our city, ripped through cities across the nation. But we've been continuously fighting back. We continuously making sure our citizens get vaccinated, people continue to wear masks. And we'd like to thank everyone who's participated in making sure that happens through all our elected officials, from our mayor, to our county executive, to our common council members, and also our county legislators. We'd like to thank you. And this year's theme is health and wellness. And the reason why we chose health and wellness, because of the pandemic. We want to make sure all our citizens continue to be safe. We hope that those get vaccinated and continue to wear your mask.
Let's pray. God, we thank you, we honor you, and we bless your name, and we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. And we thank you for this moment in time that you have allowed us to gather together in your presence, to remember those who have gone on before us and who have kept the faith and fought the good fight, to take a moment to honor those who have picked up the torch to become change agents in their city and in their community. Now, God, we ask you for your strength, God, to keep fighting and to keep pressing forward, to change the many injustices, to address the many issues that we face as a people, as a community, and as a city. God, give us the courage to keep fighting, even when we look like we're fighting a losing battle. God, give us the heart to love our neighbors as ourselves. Give us the hands to do the work in our communities, to feed the poor and to clothe the naked and to give drink to those who are thirsty. God, allow us to become better neighbors and to treat each other with love, kindness, and respect. We ask these blessings in Jesus' name. We pray. Amen.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoice facing the rise. repertory is one. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far.
Did you know I wake up in the morning after 8 hours of rest? I look in the mirror and say, yes, I'm blessed. I'm intelligent, confident, and I'm learning from my mistakes. Did you know I sit down at my table and think about my food intake? Is it fruit? Is it vegetables? Or maybe grains? While the corner store is full of sugar and salt, my cravings are insane. Yep, still in a pandemic. That means more lessons online. But I promise you and me and my blanket will be on time. Hopefully I'll have breakout rooms with my peers, the ones who have been down with me all year. My mom texts me on the side to make sure I'm in class. The love she has for me will forever last. Did you know I love history class? But I can tell by my teacher face, she hates calling on me because all I do is ask, ask, ask. Questions like, if Thomas Jefferson was so great, then why was a statue removed from City Hall in New York State? If we were freed in the United States, then why was Juneteenth recently made a day to celebrate? Did you know that Chromebooks will never replace a good book? A book of guided meditation, you know that's a good look. I breathe in, I breathe out, my feet are resting on the ground. My hands are nice and comfortable instead of moving all around. My mind is focused on pure bliss, thinking about my safe place. Yes, this is it.
Hello, my name is Malia Grant. Welcome to the Giffen Gator News. Today is a great day to have a great day.
Hi, I'm Governor Kathy Hochul. This February during Black History Month, we reflect on two things: the immense hardship historically endured by Black Americans and the progress born through their strength and unrelenting will in the fight for justice, and also how much further we need to go to honor their legacy. We must actively carry on the work that began right here in New York State. This is where the Niagara Movement, the precursor to the NAACP, was launched. It's where Sojourner Truth was born and where she gave her famous Ain't I a Woman speech. It's where Frederick Douglass used his many gifts to rally support for the abolitionist cause. And it's where Harriet Tubman made her home for half a century. It's where Dr. Martin Luther King spoke of his steadfast belief in the need for nonviolent protest, even after surviving an attempt on his life. And it's where Shirley Chisholm pulled up her folding chair to the table of power and announced, yes, a black woman can be president. New York is where the fight for racial justice has been waged for centuries. In back rooms in upstate New York, in church pulpits in Harlem and Brooklyn, and on the streets of Manhattan, and in the highest levels of government in Albany. And that fight continues today. Because while New Yorkers should have tremendous pride in this history, it cannot blind us to the failures of the present. It must not prevent us from continuing to bend the moral arc of the universe toward justice, as Dr. King said. There is just too much work left to do. We still see the ugliness of racial injustice in our society. We still see more black women dying in childbirth. We still see this pandemic disproportionately impacting black communities. We still see gun violence taking too many black lives. We still see what black Americans have long been forced to accept, that there really are two Americas, one white and one black. But if there's a silver lining to the hardship of these past few years, it's that everyone's eyes are now finally open to the injustice of these dual realities. So this Black History Month, we must seize this opportunity of this moment and renew our commitment to living up to the standards set by the civil rights heroes who called New York home. My administration is committed to ensuring equality, equity, and justice for all. We will not rest until the societal obstacles that have limited potential and put black lives at risk are finally torn down. And we must follow the words of my former colleague in Congress, John Lewis. When you see something that is not right, not just, not fair, you have a moral obligation to say something and to do something. So let's do something together. Thank you.
I'm Assemblymember Pat Fahy, and I'm here tonight to congratulate each of the honorees this year for the Black History Month celebration. It's a wonderful honor, and this is a time for us to pause and reflect while recognizing each of you, but to pause and reflect on the contributions of those of you being honored tonight, as well as so many in the Black community who have contributed to our history, to our culture, and to the social fabric of this country. We know we have so much work to do. We know structural barriers remain, as well as obstacles to success. We know we have so much work ahead of us, so much work to do. but we do need to take this time to honor the contributions of you, as well as the esteemed council members who took the time to nominate you to recognize your work. We know that the diversity of this country is what builds our strength. And that is something that we also need to reflect on. So congratulations to each of you. I look forward to continuing to work with you, as well as our council members and all of those here in the city I call home. Thank you, and again, congratulations.
Well, good evening. It's John McDonald, member of the New York State Assembly. And I want to thank the Common Council for continuing this fine tradition of the annual African American History Month celebration. And it's an honor to join with you this evening. And I want to thank all the council members first. I've had the list to review all of our honorees, all individuals who fall into that role of being ordinary citizens doing extraordinary things throughout our community. And to the council members, thank you. You know your districts and wards better than anybody else. That's why you're in office, by the way. And you've nominated great individuals, but more importantly to the honorees this evening, many of them who I know, and I'm not going to name them by name, but each of you is making a contribution to our community. Each of you is representing the interests of the people you engage with on a regular basis, whether it's in recreation, youth, healthcare, job opportunities, whatever it may be. We want to thank you for your continued efforts. We encourage you not to rest on the laurels, as you know, but to continue to build on success, because your success makes our city more successful and makes our capital region so successful. Thank you once again.
Good evening. It is my honor and my pleasure to welcome you to the Common Council's Black History Month Awards celebration. Every year, our Common Council members select members of our community to honor during Black History Month. And I am so grateful that we have residents who care so much about our community and do amazing things every day for their neighbors, for their friends, for our cultural and not-for-profit institutions, and really work to make Albany a great place to live. Thank you so much, and enjoy this celebration.
Hello everyone, my name is Jeremiah Packer. I'm a professional actor, and I've had the honor to portray one of the courageous Tuskegee Airmen in Capital Repertory Theatre's production of the play Fly by Trey Ellis and Ricardo Kahn. I'm from North Carolina, but for the past 7 weeks, I've been living here in Albany, helping to craft this exciting play about the first black fighter pilots in the US Army Air Corps during World War II. I want to thank you for the city's hospitality and support, and for the wonderful reception we've received for the play during Black History Month. We just closed our 4-week run, but I hope you will enjoy this excerpt from our production of Fly to celebrate this auspicious occasion. Thank you again, and I look forward to coming back to Albany soon. Hey!
Dr. Dorcey Applyrs, Chief City Auditor. Black History Month is about acknowledging and honoring Black people, our lives, and contributions to America and the globe. Simply put, America would not be what it is today without the contributions of Blacks. As a public health professional, I commend my colleagues on the council for prioritizing health and wellness during this year's Black History Month. Due to our traumatic history and current day experiences as Black people in America, we often have some of the poorest health outcomes when compared to other Americans. The role that systemic racism, oppression, and implicit and explicit bias play in contributing to these outcomes cannot be ignored. So in light of Black History Month, I join my council colleagues in acknowledging the contributions Blacks have made and continue to make in improving the health and well-being for Blacks in other communities. Despite the many challenges we have faced in this country due to systemic racism, we have endured and survived some of the most horrific circumstances because of our resilience, resourcefulness, strength, faith, and communal ties. Research has shown that these qualities and assets serve as a protective factor and should be focused on when seeking to address and eliminate health disparities and poor health outcomes in Black communities. In closing, it is an honor to participate in this year's Black History Month program. I am deeply proud of our legacy as a people and continue to be inspired by our past, our present, and our future.
And now for our keynote speaker, Dr. Brenda Robinson.
Hi, my name is Dr. Brenda Robinson, and it's a pleasure to be here. As we celebrate Black History Month and highlight Black health and wellness, let us all commit to change. People of color tackle health inequities built on the foundation of racism and discrimination each and every day. These disparities are impacted by the social determinants of health as well. We must remember and harness our own power, the power of one, the power of many. Decades and decades of unequal treatment resulting in disparities has been highlighted by the COVID-19 pandemic. African Americans have the worst health outcomes of almost any disease that you can think of. According to the latest New York State Department of Health stats, 2016-18, per 100,000 people, the mortality rates of Black people due to stroke is 42.6 compared to 25.7 for white people. Here in Albany County, the mortality rates for diabetes is 31.5 for Black people compared to 14.9 for white people. Did you know that? These are disparities. Did you know New York State data reports 97% of all COVID-19 fatalities had a comorbid condition, with hypertension being number one and diabetes being number two? Did you know that? And of course, Black people have the highest rates of hypertension and diabetes, along with the mortality rates to match. There are many other disparities, such as breast cancer and the maternal mortality rates of Black women. These disparities are not new and exist across the country. If you have hypertension, take your medication as prescribed. If you have issues, try taking your medications at night, and also be sure to inform your primary care provider. And if you don't have a primary care, get one. If you suffer from diabetes, check your blood sugar often and as directed by your provider. Take your medication as ordered and report any issues. Uncontrolled hypertension and diabetes impact your kidneys, your heart, and other systems as well. We need to change the paradigm of healthcare when it comes to minorities. The track record is poor. Healthcare, disease management, and prevention has to be person-centric. This means using an equity lens when we look at policies, procedures, funding, access, the workforce, care delivery, and all other aspects of health. Accountability has been elusive, but if we all commit to improving Black health and wellness, we all benefit. Did you know that prevention and delivery of culturally competent care is much less expensive than a hospitalization? Improving Black health and wellness is a priority. It's not just in the month of February. It's not just a New Year's resolution. It is daily work, daily action. It is the power of one and the power of many. Being aware of these disparities and acknowledgement is a part of the work. Taking responsibility for your own health and those close to you is the work. Being our brothers and sisters' keeper is the work. Being an advocate, not only for yourself, but for others, is the work. Supporting those who work in this space is the work. Building partnerships is the work. Holding people and businesses accountable is the work. Creating and demanding diversity and inclusion certainly is the work. Commit to being that agent of change and putting in that work. Albany made history with the appointment of the first Black chief of surgery. We are also making history with many of you who are making a difference by improving your own health and the health of others. That primary care appointment you just had, that mammogram or colonoscopy you had last week was a great step for you and those around you. Share that information with others. Stay engaged with your own body and your health. So as we continue to celebrate Black inventors, creators, Black first, and remember slavery and other maltreatment, and highlight the importance of Black health and wellness, despite it all, let's remember the tenacity of Black people as we are still here, standing strong, the power of one, the power of many. Thank you so much.
Recite a poem.
Yeah!
I can see the words in front of me, though. Self-help. Common sense is considered an uncommon luxury. Yet what we have in common is this simplistic birth-giving way of thinking. So your life is like the perfect instrumental melody. But the wrong lyrics are staticky, annoyingly distorted. Consider the human body. A complex, well-oiled machine. Piece by piece, it speaks simplicity. Now, compare you and me to a Lamborghini. If it needs Ultra 93 to run optimally, you can't afford to be cheap and gas it up regularly. See, eventually it may break down when you least expect in greater need. A body in motion stays in motion, at rest, stays at rest. It wants to do what you want to do. Like when you're thinking of eating fast food, when you get up and on the move, your body's automatically following you. It has no choice. It humbly serves you and never attacks you. These are three elementary everys I never learned from elementary to universities. Every 90 days, the body produces new bones. 11 months, new cells. 2 years, new bones. In these short times, you are physically renewed. However, it can't rebuild greater than the food or fuel you use. Whatever you choose to consume is what it uses to reproduce you. So if you consume a lot of processed and fast foods, that chiseled, curvy, number 8 figure quickly disfigures to a 0. And high stress catches high metabolisms, like when you're barely 21, already plucking out gray hairs. Damn. See, social society's lyrics have subtly, persuasively bamboozled you not to use your birth-given common sense since. You didn't hear the signals? Pain is the last way your body gets your attention. Listen, you don't need an operation. Just cooperate with you. 95% of every problem in the body comes from a storage of waste. So when your waist expands out of shape, it's a lie when the doctors claim it's genetically hereditary. So let me give it to you straight. You're full of shit. You and them, but you literally excrement. Your bowels are suffering from constipation when diarrhea is your friend. A fever is your friend. Think of vomiting as a defensive reaction. Yeah, I know. It sounds like a disgustingly dirty job, but somebody's gotta cleanse your sewage system, the colon. See, when you pass that SBD gas, something's rotting inside. When you're weak or sick, your body's using its resources to get you back to 100%. Pain is sickness leaving the body when handled with care. When you see lumps and bumps in odd places, it's nothing cancerous, no disease. It means it's trying to inadvertently exit something that you're not willingly emptying. If you're gaining unwanted weight, it's not a complex situation. It's one of two or both things. You have a high stress level or you're eating the wrong things. But all of America's overweight due to big food corporations, super pharmaceuticals that profit by creating a nation of sick and fat citizens. Cheap, low quality foods are the majority that rule television commercials from the diners to your dining room. The supermarket, government institutions, your jobs, the schools, selling you junk food like a beautifully smooth poison, killing you softer than a Roberta Flack tune. See, this system is vicious when you relinquish common sense. You are the greatest physician dietitian you will ever meet. So why choose to listen to somebody else instead of yourself? Get a PhD in self, personal health development. Like there's no two snowflakes alike, everybody is different. Your life is the perfect instrumental melody when you apply your own lyrics.
Good evening. My name is Kelly Kimbrough, and I'm the Fourth Ward Council Member and President Pro Temp for the Albany Common Council. Welcome to our annual Black History Month celebration. My honoree in the Fourth Ward for this year will be Mr. Elijah Willingham. Mr. Willingham is a true son of Albany. He was born and raised here. He attended Albany Public Schools and met and married his wife here and raised their family here in Albany. When I think of Mr. Willingham, the phrase village raising a child comes to mind. Mr. Willingham looks out for the community and our kids, whether it's organizing the Stop the Violence basketball tournaments, community cookouts, and block parties. Mr. Willingham works for his community. Mr. Willingham has worked from Arbor Hill to North Albany and everything in between towards the betterment of Albany. He continually shows up and looks out for his community. As a member of the Sons of Arbor Hill, Mr. Willingham worked on fundraising for an annual Grafton State Park trip and holiday parties for the community. Mr. Willingham's love of Albany has driven him to also push for recognition of the work and accomplishments of many other Albany residents. Making sure folks that mean something to our community get recognized. Whether it's William Hank Wallace, Charles Chucky Trainum, Mr. Barry Sparks, the businessman, or the DeLucas from Taylorama, Mr. Willingham has directly engaged the city of Albany to have them recognized or was closely involved in it somehow. And lest we forget the great wall of fame at the Arbor Hill softball field, which Mr. Willingham had dedicated. So thank you for your service to this community, Mr. Willingham. It's my honor to recognize you.
Hi, I'm Ginnie Farrell. I'm the 13th Ward Common Council Representative, and I'm so honored to introduce our African American History Month honoree, Kim Wallace. Kim Wallace is a brilliant attorney that believes in giving back. She serves on the board of several nonprofits and has been honored for her extensive pro bono work. She's also someone with vision. She's a partner in the Wallace Turner Law Firm, which provides, and I quote, because I love it, high quality, ethically sound, strategically positive legal counsel to the area. And if that's not enough, Wallace Turner happens to be the only law firm in the area owned by two Black women. She grew up in Kingston, Jamaica, and moved to Albany and graduated from Bishop McGinn High School, got her bachelor's at Sage College of Albany, and after law school at Florida State University, returned to Albany to make a difference. Kim is an absolute inspiration. She doesn't just recognize the needs of a community, she works to fill those needs and to change things for the better. Albany is better because of Kim's intelligence and hard work, and the 13th Ward is so proud to have her as one of our own. Thank you, Kim, for all you do for Albany and the 13th Ward. We are so proud that you are one of our constituents, and we can't wait to see what you do next. You are an incredible inspiration. Thank you.
It's my pleasure to honor Ms. Jeanette Oliver as the first ward recipient for the Albany Common Council's African American History Month celebration. Jeanette has been truly dedicated to her community all of her life, and she's a staple here in the first ward. Jeanette worked for many years at the Department of Social Services, fighting for everyday rights, including helping out our children, fighting for tenant rights, and making sure public housing issues were addressed, and working with our most vulnerable populations, making sure that they had enough meals, enough food, as well as shelter, and connecting them to the appropriate resources, including social workers. In addition, she's been extremely active within the political atmosphere of Albany. She's helped on a number of state campaigns and local campaigns as well, including prior and current administrations, as well as Common Council leadership and Common Council seats. She's also a very proud mother of eight, and she has truly built a strong village around her, and now she's a proud grandmother of 14 grandchildren. I wanted to honor Jeanette today because she is truly deserving, and she's been really dedicated to serving her community consistently. She's also extremely humble, and she's often had a leadership position behind the scenes and not necessarily given the recognition that she deserves. So this is extremely overdue, extremely well-deserved. And Jeanette, we are so proud to have you here in the first ward, and thank you so much for your service.
Good evening. I'm Councilman Derek Johnson, and I'm here to talk about our honoree, Mr. Greg Foskey. Mr. Greg Foskey has been running the youth programs at Trinity Institute since 2006. In that time, he has built many relationships with our youth and our families and our community. It is often that I utilize Mr. Foskey's name when we share kids that may have difficulties during the day, and I know that they are going to go see Mr. Foskey at night, and I use his name and the kids respond, and it's like having a tool in a tool bag, being able to have Mr. Foskey as a partner in the work that we do. So, and knowing Mr. Foskey and those that know him, they know that he's never one to want to be in the limelight. So it took a little coercion by the councilman, who also happens to be a friend of Mr. Foskey, to remind him that kids need to see his family, you know, the community needs to see and get and have the opportunity to recognize him and give him a chance to smell his roses. You can look at the program and see the long list of accomplishments that he had. I want to make him comfortable in this presentation, and I don't want to get long-winded. But Greg is he's always the example that our kids need, because he not only talks it, but he walks the walk. And it's important that our kids see the adults in their lives modeling the initiatives that we are presenting to them. So I just wanted to say to Mr. Foskey, thank you for allowing us to bring attention to your great work that you do down at Trinity and the other programs that you're touching. And we just wanted to say thank you to the family for sharing him with us. You know, it's a special relationship that exists with the people that he comes in contact with. It's much needed, and we are grateful to have him in our city representing, connecting with our youth, connecting with our families. And so we want to say thank you, thank you, thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Joyce Love, and I represent the Third Ward. Tierra Brandon is a native of Albany. She's a social entrepreneur and the owner of three businesses. She's a member of Metropolitan Baptist Church, where she serves on the usher board. She's also a proud mother of two. Tierra is the owner of Blowing Smoke in the city of Albany, a place where you can go after work, relax, and enjoy yourself and unwind. That is why she is my honoree for Black History Month.
City. She is an Albany Library Board trustee. She serves on the 5th Ward Democratic Committee. And during the COVID-19 pandemic, she played a crucial role in working with the Black Nurses Coalition to ensure that our community had access to vaccinations, to booster shots, and also to PPE. Jare is truly a change agent, and she is committed to changing the narrative in our community and in our city. Thank you, Jare, for all the work that you have done and continue to keep up the good work. Congratulations.
Hi, everyone. My name is Gabriella Romero, and I am the Common Council member for Albany's Common Council in the 6th Ward. For this year's Black History Month, I will be honoring Rashid Howell, who is a lifelong Albany resident and one of the three youth co-founders of YouthFX. Rashid attended the Albany Free School, Green Tech High School, and finally the College of St. Rose, and he graduated there in 2017 with a major in communications and a minor in business. Rashid currently serves as YouthFX Technical Director, and YouthFX as an organization focuses on work with young people of color who reside in the South End, Arbor Hill, and West Hill neighborhoods of Albany. YouthFX's main mission is to empower young people by teaching them both the technical and creative aspects of digital filmmaking, storytelling, and just general creative expression. Rashid and I both believe that organizations like YouthFX are so important to our larger community, and really it's YouthFX and these similar organizations that provide a real opportunity for organized play, but also an opportunity to develop problem-solving skills, leadership, and confidence for our youth. Rashid really is a role model and a leader for youth in Albany, and for that, we thank him.
Greetings, this is 7th Ward Council Member Sergio Adams. I'm taking this time to make this video in honor of the Albany Common Council's African American History Month celebration. This is a great opportunity for the city to recognize and acknowledge the contributions and hard work of its residents here in the city of Albany, past and present. This year, I would like to honor and acknowledge Coach Carmen Duncan and the Mission Accomplished Service team for their hard work and dedication to the community. Coach Carmen Duncan is a social entrepreneur. She is the chief coach and founder of Mission Accomplished Transition Services, a nonprofit career education organization established in December 2012. The mission of the company is to prepare rising young individuals and professionals and entrepreneurs for the workforce by providing specific industry training, coaching, mentorship, and sponsorship. The company is primarily focused on the advancement of rising young professionals in Black and Brown communities and businesses operated and owned. The motivation and development of the career, mentorship programs, and coaching is to give low-income to middle-income communities access to influential industry professionals who have the power to break through barriers in a meaningful way to help establish well-paying careers and create revenue for businesses. Coach Carmen comes from very humble beginnings. She is a survivor of homelessness and the impact of community substance abuse, street violence, incarceration. It was through establishing close bonds and relationships with mentors that helped guide Ms. Duncan. Through her teenage years and her early adulthood, Ms. Duncan has utilized mentorship as a way to not only improve herself, but improve the others around her. Since the founding of Mission Accomplished, Coach Carmen has raised over $1 million to help operate programs and create jobs here in the community. Her team has provided career mentorship, coaching, and sponsorship to over 3,000 emerging young professionals and entrepreneurs here in the city of Albany and surrounding area. I want to salute and congratulate Coach Carmen and the Mission Accomplished team for their hard work. The city of Albany is grateful to have people like you working and changing the community and people around you. So thank you and happy Black History Month.
Hi, this is Councilmember Jack Flynn. It is my honor and pleasure to introduce you to Angela O'Neill. Miss O'Neill was born and raised in Albany and attended St. Agnes School and the Academy of the Holy Names. She graduated from Hobart and William Smith College with a Bachelor of Arts in English and Art History in 1983. With a background that included theater work in the MA program at the University of Albany, she began her career with the New York State Martin Luther King Jr. Commission in 1987. Her work helped her to establish the first New York State Arts and Sciences Competition and other youth-oriented programs. She later began a career in fundraising as a development officer at the University of Albany and later the Newark Museum in New Jersey. Angela recently retired from her position as the Major Gifts and Planned Giving Officer of Institutional Advancement for the Hudson Valley Community College Foundation in Troy, New York. In her role, she led the advancement team in reaching numerous fundraising goals through grant writing and donor stewardship. She takes great pride in having administered and secured funding for the scholarship programs, which generates more than $200,000 in awards to students each year. Angela was previously the executive director of the African American Cultural Center of the Capital Region in downtown Albany. Angela says, quote, "This was a calling for me. We built this organization for the next generation. My focus was to bring in young people and show them that this is their center. We heard their ideas about how to showcase African American culture and took it to the next level." The position stood as a return to her roots for Angela. Her grandfather, Edmund O'Neill Sr., was an assistant principal at Hackett Middle School. Her father, Edmund O'Neill Jr., became Albany School District's first African-American principal when he took over leadership of the former School 6. He was the first principal of Arbor Hill Elementary School when it opened in 1973 and later served as a school district administrator. In addition, the O'Neill family is honored that the new middle school at 50 North Lark Street was named the Edmund J. O'Neill Middle School of Excellence. Miss O'Neill was one of the proud recipients of the Omega Psi Phi New Tau Chapter Woman of Color Awards in 2017 and served on the board of directors for Trinity Alliance of the Capital District Interfaith Community Partnerships at Hudson Valley Community College and a graduate of the Leadership Institute class of 2020 with the Rensselaer Chamber of Commerce. In addition, Angela is a proud member of the Albany District NY Chapter of the Lynx Incorporated. Congratulations, Angela.
Hello, my name is Owusu Anani. I'm the 10th Ward Councilman for the Pine Hills neighborhood. And today it gives me great pleasure to recognize our friend, our neighbor, Virginia Rawlins. Virginia is the president and CEO of Building Blocks Together, an organization that's mission is to help residents with home ownership to build equity, particularly in disenfranchised communities and marginalized communities. Virginia is a hard worker. Virginia is committed to the community and has done phenomenal work over the past couple of years. The 10th Ward is proud of her. I am proud of her. And so many people in our city are proud of the work that she's doing. Being an African American is not an easy task, but so is anything impossible. Like Flowing River, we are moving along. Virginia's story is an example of not just achieving personal goals, but also achieving goals for friends, neighbors, and making sure that we all have a path towards the middle class. Throughout American history, the path to the middle class has always been home ownership. And Virginia understands this, and that's why her organization worked day and night to make sure that everyone in our city and the capital region achieved the American dream. On behalf of the 10th Ward and the city as a whole, Virginia, we are proud of you. Congratulations. And we look forward to working with you and moving our city, our neighborhood, our state forward. Thank you.
Thank you everyone for joining us at our annual Black History Month celebration. Each year, we take some time to honor the hard work and dedication of so many of our residents that make our city a better place to live. This year, I'm honored to recognize David Gordon. David is a longtime resident of the 11th Ward. He is an alumni from SUNY Schenectady and SUNY New Paltz. He's worked for SUNY Music, the Albany School District, and KIPP Community Charter School. Currently, he is working with the Boys and Girls Club as program manager and overseeing Lyricist 101. I met David a few years ago, and he told me about the hard work he was doing with our young people. He explained to me how he was using music as a way to get young people engaged, young people to use their creativity and their passion to create new artwork. And he told me how the positive work that he was doing. In 2019, he volunteered at the Boys and Girls Club as Lyricist 101 coordinator. He took that and grew that program so that in 2020, in the middle of the pandemic, the Boys and Girls Club and David worked hard to fundraise $150,000 to create the Lyricist Mobile. A RV was converted into a mobile studio with a sound room, keyboard, and displays to be able to actually do what they were doing at the center anywhere in our city. And it's exactly what we needed at the time, and it's exactly what we need right now to be able to mobilize the resources to where they are most needed. So thank you, David. Thank you, the Boys and Girls Club. Thank you for your leadership. Thank you for your vision. Thank you for thinking outside the box of how you can use your skills, your passions, your strengths to make our city a better place, to give our young people a focus, to give our young people a hope, to give our young people a safe haven, and to use the energy that they have to create something positive and beautiful. So thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you continue to do. Know that we are all here to support you in any way that we can, and we appreciate your hard work. And we appreciate how you are helping develop our young people into the young men and women we need them to be. Thank you.
My name is Edward Hyde Clark, and I'm the Common Council member from the 12th Ward. It is an honor and privilege to recognize James Frizzell as this year's 12th Ward nominee in honor and celebration of African History Month here in the city of Albany. James has been a friend, a neighbor. We've worked together on the 12th Ward Democratic Committee. He's an active member with the Upper Washington Avenue Neighborhood Association. But more importantly, over James's life, he's been active in the fight for racial equality and standing up for injustices, not only here in the city of Albany, but across the country. James was one of the first group to be recruited to the Naval Academy to play football to help break the color barrier. You'll see in James's bio that some of the adversity that he faced, the discrimination, and the fact that he stood up to that He continued to dedicate his life to fighting against racial inequality, continues to work with the Naval Academy to make sure that they're recruiting minority members to be a part of our service academies. He currently serves on Congressman Paul Tonko's Service Command Academy Selection Committee. And just going through everything that James has worked on in terms of helping veterans in the labor workforce program for Governor Cuomo, in addition to his work with Albany County NAACP, Metropolitan 500, just every effort that James has made to stand up to racial inequality is commendable. And as my first term on the council, it's an honor to recognize James this year. So please join me in saluting James Frizzell as the 12th Ward nominee in honor of Black History Month here in the city of Albany. Thank you.
My name is Deborah Zamer. I'm the Albany Common Council member for the 14th Ward, and I'm very happy to participate in this year's Black History Month celebration by recognizing a neighbor and a 14th Ward resident, Harriet Webster. Harriet has dedicated her life to helping others. She began her career as an educator, a mentor, and a youth counselor, where she helped countless young people. And it didn't stop when the workday ended. Harriet didn't just talk the talk, she walked the walk. She became a foster and adoptive mother, opening her home to children in need. Harriet also opened her home for an annual dinner called First Fruits, where she invited the community to come together for food and fellowship. She continues to provide food for the community through Harriet's Kitchen, a catering business here in Albany. Those who know Harriet well told me that for years, she has always been there to help a young person, to provide food, and to give guidance. I'm honored to recognize Harriet Webster for Black History Month, and I'm grateful for her contributions to the 14th Ward and to the city of Albany as a whole.
Hello, I am 15th Ward Common Council Member Tom Hoey. The 15th Ward of Albany is located in the Eagle Hill neighborhood and contains much of the uptown campus of the University at Albany. I am here today to honor Dr. Annette Johnson, who is a faculty member of the university and a City of Albany resident. Dr. Johnson teaches at the School of Public Health and in the Department of Africana Studies. She's my nominee for the City of Albany Black History Month celebration. As a public health professional, Dr. Johnson has focused much of her work on educating students, community members, and colleagues on the health and wellness issues and how they are influenced by social and environmental factors. Dr. Johnson's community work is extensive and deserves praise and thanks. For example, she serves on the Albany Board of the NAACP and the Giffen School Advisory Committee, the South End Tutoring Program, the Equinox Board, and the list goes on and on. She is an individual who gives back to the community, and we are lucky to have her represent our city and her work to make our lives healthy and safe. Thank you, Dr. Annette Johnson.
I'm David Allen Miller, Music Director of the Albany Symphony. We're so excited to celebrate the great impact of Black creative artists through our programming and special projects in the community, including Convergence, an exploration of Black cultural traditions, including music, dance, and spoken word. We're also celebrating the Empire State Trail this year, and we hope you'll join us this summer for music and health and wellness events in Albany and across the region as part of our Trailblaze Festival. Please enjoy this clip of Jesse Montgomery's Coincident Dances, a piece inspired by the musical melange of sounds on a walk through the city. Learn more about all of our projects at albanysymphony.com. Thank you.
What an absolute privilege and honor it is to be able to provide our closing prayer for our 2022 Black History Month celebration. Would you please join me in a word of prayer? God, so grateful we are that you've allowed us to virtually come together to celebrate those who have come before us, God, to celebrate those who are still in our midst, who have blazed trails that so many have been able to not only walk through, but run through. We're grateful, God, that we are able to turn up the volume just a little bit more during the month of February. But let us be reminded that everywhere we walk, we are surrounded by Black excellence. Let us be reminded, God, that there are very few places in the world, very few resources that we can utilize that are not interwoven with the excellence, innovation, and intellect of Black people. And so, God, we don't just pause during February, but we celebrate throughout the entire year. So grateful we are for those in whose shoulders we stand. So grateful we are for those in who've come before us so that we can have rights, liberties, and access to education. God, our prayer is that as we close out this program, that each and every one of us would look internally at ourselves to make sure that we are doing all that we can to ensure equity in our communities and to amplify Black voices. This is our prayer, and we're so grateful, God, that you have kept us another day. Watch over us as only you can. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.